Hey everyone, John here with Photography Life, and today we're going to talk about the graduated filter tool in Lightroom. So I'm going to show you what it is, where you can find it, and how you use it. So let's go ahead and jump right in here. I have this gray image pulled up, and that's pretty much just something that makes it easier to see what's happening. And I'll also go in and edit a real image with it, and you can see how it actually works, but this kind of helps you visualize what's going on just a bit better. So the first thing we need to do is figure out where it is. So under the histogram here, we have this toolbar, and it's this one that looks kind of like an upright rectangle. If you hover over it, it says graduated filter, and you could see that M is the keyboard shortcut. So you can either click here or you can press M and it'll open and close that toolbar here. So let's go ahead and run down what we see here before we start using it. Now this mask section basically just creates a new graduated filter. So when you have more than one, or you apply one and you want to apply a new one, you can hit new. You can also just hit the enter button, which does the same thing. Now in this section, we have all these different values we can adjust, and we can do it through these presets up here, which will go and kind of do one particular thing, or we can manually set them down here. You can also do more than one at the same time. So if you wanted to say decrease exposure and increase contrast in one filter, you can do that. But I don't want to do that, so let's just set this back to zero. So in order to really see what's going on, I'm going to drop this exposure down by about two stops, and we'll go ahead and apply a graduated filter to this gray image. So what you do, you just click anywhere on the edge of the screen or the edge of the image and drag, and you'll see these three lines appear. Now you can see what happened. We have this dark area and it gradually goes to a lighter area and then gradually goes to our original exposure. And this darkest area up here is our minus 1.9 stop decrease in exposure, and then everything past this line here is our original exposure, and from here to here it gradually changes, and that's why it's called a graduated filter. So what we can do also to really see what's happening, if we show the selected mask overlay, we can go down here, click this box, and you can see the red makes it a little bit easier to see what's happening. We have this solid red gradually disappearing to nothing. And if you don't want to click down here, you can also just hover here for a quick peek. And as soon as you move your mouse away off of this pin, then that red disappears, that mask overlay disappears. So that's kind of a quick idea of what happens. And this, keep in mind, I'm just affecting the exposure. You can do this with other settings as well, and I'll show you in a real image how that works. Now, before we do that though, I do want to point out, if you want to move this, you can. So you can see when I hover over these arrows, my pointer, my cursor changes, so I can rotate this some if I want to, and you can see how that affects the image. I can also drag this and expand it or decrease it. And when I do this, the farther apart these lines are, the more gradual the change. The closer together they are, the more abrupt the change. So you can see here, it's a very abrupt transition, whereas here, it's a very gradual transition across the entire image. I can also click this and move it out here, so I can have more of the image affected by this solid decrease in exposure, and then it gradually changes out here towards the pin. Now I can add more than one at the same time. If I drag this back up here, let's go ahead and add another one coming from this corner, and you can see now I have these two different filters added. This one up here changed this corner, this one over here changed this corner, and if I want to switch back and forth between the two, I just click on these pins. Now finally, if I wanted to go in and edit this one, and maybe I have a decrease in exposure, but I wanted to instead increase the exposure, I can change it after the fact once I've already put it down. So any of these are not set in stone. You can go in and adjust them if you want to after you've already put the filter down. And it's a little bit more obvious. I'll show you how that works in a real image. So let's go ahead and jump over to do that now. I'm gonna hit enter to accept those and move over to this image that I want to add a few graduated filters to. So on here, what I'm thinking is I really want to just kind of put a little more focus on my couple here, and I want to just kind of darken up the edges of this image. I might also want to make it just a little more green, and I'll show you how to do that. So let's just go ahead and start out with a basic burn filter. I don't want that extreme exposure change. And let's just drop it in here, and you can see already that made this part of the image get just a little bit darker. I don't want to go crazy. I don't want to make it too dark, but I do want to make the focus a little bit more on my couple and a little bit less on these trees out here. So I'm just going to quickly add a couple here. So let's do one here. Maybe one from this bottom because it's a little distracting. And if I hit enter, you can see how much this has changed the image already. If I go down to this little toggle switch here, I can turn all of the filters off and on again. And you can see what happened when I added just three filters really quickly. It really brought the focus onto my couple. Now, another really cool thing that you can do is, like I said, you can add more than one change to a filter if you want to, and I'm going to go ahead and do that to this one up here. What I want to do is maybe add just a little bit of green and make it look a little more like they're out in nature and not quite so yellow. And so what I'm going to do is go down here into this color, maybe just click through until I see something that looks pretty nice, and maybe just, you know, change the saturation just a little bit up to 10. And let's go ahead and close out of that. And it's a really, really subtle change up here. But again, if I turn it off and turn it back on, you can see it kind of just makes this back here look a little bit more green. Now, this isn't something that I'll do all the time. You don't want to do it to every single image, but it is a good trick to have if you want to make your foliage or different parts of your image look a little more vibrant and lush like these trees back here. Now, one thing I do want to point out is if I had this pulled up here, and let's say I wanted all of this back here to look green, but maybe I'm worried about a little bit of green getting onto my couple here, there's a really easy way to change that and to keep this filter off of parts of your image that you don't want it on. If I go over here, you can see there is this brush option, and it opens up this new little section down here. So let's take a look at this and see what we can do. Now, I can go in and I can brush this in if I wanted to in new parts of my image, but that's not necessarily what I want or how I want to use this brush tool. So let's go ahead and undo that. And instead, I want to erase. And this erase is very valuable whether you're changing exposure, adding color, whatever you're doing. The erase brush you will find yourself using fairly often when you're using graduated filters. So let's turn on this mask overlay and see exactly where this filter is. And I can see some of it got on here. It's a bit easier to see when it's red than when it's green. And let's go ahead and just erase off of her veil, out of her hair. And you can see that instantly changing. Like I said, the red makes it pretty easy to see what's going on, whereas that green was kind of subtle and was hard to see exactly where it was. So I just want to erase all of this red off of her. Hit O to turn that off, and now I don't have to worry about any green getting in here, even though it's all here in my background. So hopefully that gave you a quick idea of how this works and how you might use it in real image. There's one more thing I want to show you. Let's jump back over here to this gray example and go ahead and go into the develop module. And one thing you'll probably want to do, you'll use graduated filters a lot in landscapes when you have skies, when you have different things like that, and there's usually a flat horizon, and you probably want to apply the filter fairly flat. So you can always go in and drag it in if you wanted to, and you know, try and get it as flat as possible. But another thing that you can do is hold down the shift key, and it's going to give you a perfectly straight one. And no matter what I do with my mouse here, I can't move it around and twist it. It's going to always give me one that's parallel to the side that I started on. So it works from the side as well. Hold down the shift key and pull in, and it's perfectly parallel to this side. Now, granted, you can always change it after the fact if you want to, but it's a really great trick to getting straight graduated filters. Well, I hope you found this useful. If you did, please consider subscribing so you don't miss our upcoming videos. Also, head on over to photographylife.com where you can find some news, reviews, and photography tips and tricks, and we'll see you next time.